Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Warren Edward Buffett, a legend in the field of investing. Every new investor wants to replicate Buffett's success. His followers keep saying, buy and hold companies for a long period of time and your wealth is bound to compound. However, taking decisions in real life is not as easy as preaching theory. What if I asked you to invest a major part of your wealth in a company when no one is willing to invest a single penny in it? You will call me insane. But one of Warren Buffett's most iconic investments was exactly what one would describe as daredevilry. Let's find out what exactly happened. American Express. It is one of the biggest financial services companies in the world. Millions of people use Amex cards, and having an Amex card is considered as a status symbol. However, in the 1960s, an event happened that put Amex in a very bad position, and people started questioning the ability of the company to survive. This event was the salad oil scandal. Let me explain this scandal. Now, whenever we want to take a loan from a bank, we need to give some collateral. Let's say I have a gold bar which is worth rupees 10,000. I want to take a loan by keeping this gold bar as a collateral. If I go to a bank with this gold bar, then they will check the value of this bar and then, based on their policies, they will sanction a loan. In practical life, the value of the collateral is generally higher than the value of the loan. So let's say the bank gives me a loan of 8,000 rupees against the gold bar of rupees 10,000. In case I am unable to repay the loan, then the bank will sell the collateral, that is the gold bar, and recover their money. However, if I repay the loan, then they will return my gold bar. So you see, for a bank, a collateral is like an insurance against major losses. There was a company named Allied Crude Vegetable Oil Company. This company was owned by Anthony De Angelis. This company had a lot of inventory of salad oil as it was engaged in the business of exporting salad oil. Anthony devised a strategy using which he could increase the company's profits. He kept the salad oil inventory as collateral and took loans from financial institutions. He used the proceeds of the loan to buy oil futures. Now, I'll explain futures in a separate video, but you can consider futures as an instrument using which Anthony can gain from an increase in oil prices. Now, using this strategy, Anthony used to increase the prices of oil. Due to this increase in price, not only did the value of salad oil inventory go up, but also the futures that he bought went up. His profits started increasing. However, Anthony got greedy and he started to show false records to get more and more loans from financial institutions and increase his profits even further. What he did was, he showed that he had more inventory than he actually owned. Now, you must be wondering, how did Anthony show more inventory than what he actually had? He used to fill the tanks with water and then he added a thin layer of salad oil to it. Water is denser than oil, so the oil used to float on the water and it appeared as if the tanks were full of oil, while in reality it was mostly water. The collateral was actually worthless because it was not oil and majority of it was water. American Express was one of the largest providers of loans against this collateral, which was worthless. The fraud was exposed when someone from Allied Crude Vegetable Oil Company asked inspectors from American Express to check one of the largest tanks of salad oil. It was then that they realized that the whole thing was a fraud. Anthony and his company were exposed and both went bankrupt after oil futures crashed. They were left with nothing. Financial institutions like American Express, who had given out loans against this collateral, suffered huge losses because the value of collateral was nowhere near the value of the loans. Remember, I told you that in practical life, the value of the loan is generally lesser than the value of the collateral. Banks do this to make sure that they don't suffer loss from depreciation in the value of collateral. However, in this case, the collateral was completely worthless, and hence the entire loan amount was lost and the financial institutions suffered huge losses. American Express stock fell more than 40% as people felt that American Express would not be able to bear the losses. However, Warren Buffett had a different opinion. He felt that despite the short-term problems that the company is facing, the company's main business of cards and traveler's checks was intact. The company had loyal customers and its future was bright. Due to his analysis and belief, Warren Buffett invested $20 million in American Express for a 5% stake. He invested in American Express stock at very low prices because no one in the market was willing to hold Amex due to the salad oil scandal, while Warren Buffett was quite confident. He invested a major part of his wealth in this company. That was the level of confidence he had in his instinct. This investment turned out to be a huge success. American Express stock doubled within 3 years of this investment. The company kept growing and Warren Buffett earned millions of dollars from the American Express stock. Even today, that is 6 decades after this incident, Warren Buffett's company Berkshire Hathaway still holds American Express stock. What is the learning from this incident? It is easy to know what is right and what is wrong from theory. We all know that we should buy at lows and sell at highs. That is what theory teaches us. However, most of us are afraid to invest at lows because we fear that the stock is going to fall further. It is quite important that we believe in what we have learned and take calculated risks. If you have any doubts, please mention them in the comment section. I would be glad to answer. If you have any video suggestions or you want to discuss any topic with me, then you can connect with me on social media. I've put the links in the description box. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for my upcoming videos. Do share it with your friends and family who might be interested in finance. Stay tuned. Thank you.